Now in this second case, we need to change all those background properties over here, like this red colored background. Then here comes the amber color, this green color, this blue color. So each and individual of this background properties, those are needed to be changed into those particular images, those we are using right over here. So that is why all we can do, we can see practically that there are some classes over here right now, like this amber, this green, blue, all those things are right over here. So what are the exact purposes of it? Let's get back to our code inspector panel again. Choose any of these classes, and this is the class red, which is determining this background color over here, this red color. It is practically being determined by this individual class over here, this red. So if we now turn it off, this is the background of the slider holder that we have used so far. Remember, this is the background property of this slider holder. So it is individually presenting this red color over here. Get back to your project. This is the thing that we are right now seeing over here. Instead of this one, if we get to this amber class, this one is the amber class, and we can see if we turn it off, we can see actually that the background color property is now disappeared. So all those classes, this red, this amber, this blue and green, all of these classes, those are individually responsible for the background color that we are seeing over here. So we have to replace all those classes, and we have to insert our own classes over here. So instead of red, if we now use here CC1, instead of amber, if we now use here CC2, instead of green, we are using here CC3 class, and instead of this blue class, if we use now CC4 and press Ctrl S, get back to our project and reload, we will see that each individual, those particular classes, red, amber, green, those are practically gone. If we now click right over here, this is the first one, div class carousel item. We can see that CC1 is in activation. That means we have successfully implemented our own custom classes. Now we have to modify these classes, and if we modify these classes with that individual background image property, then we will be successful in implementing our own images as the background image of this carousel slider. And this is the exact thing that we are about to do over here. Close this code inspector panel first, get back to your project, and we have named them as CC1, CC2, CC3, CC4. So all we are going to do, we are getting back to stylesheet.css, and here first of all we are putting the background image property. What was the name of the folder? This is the name of the folder, images, and inside this images folder, we are going to use all those file names. So this is the first one, images. Then comes the file name. So we will be using this 1.jpg, then we'll be using 4, 5, and 6. So this is the first one, and let's put on this syntax over here. So all we have to do now, we have to copy this whole entire thing, and we have to paste it over here 3 more times. This is the CC2, and we will be using here Twit image. This is the CC3, and we will be using here for say fourth image, and this is CC4, we will be using here sixth image. Now if we get back to our project and reload, we will see that our images, those are right into action, and all of them are currently working. But on the other hand, there are some problems we can see. Those are not yet full width. Actually, we haven't put that individual property. We can see that there's a certain background repeat condition over here. The image is now practically repeating itself. So we need to check on all those properties in an order to make it sustainable into our carousel slider. So that is why we will be getting back and we will be putting them all here. Now, what will be the background properties right over here? So the first thing that we want to appear here, that this image, it is practically occupying the whole width of this individual block level element. This is the first thing that we are wanting to do over here. That is why we will be putting this background size as cover. Then we will be restricting the repeat condition. We will be saying that it will be under no repeat condition, and if we want to position them into proper places, then here it goes. We will center our images. So press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload. And now we can see that each of those things are working. Just observe all of these images, whether they are working or not. Okay, we can see that these images, those are practically covering this whole width here. Those are all proper in position. Those are well contained within it, within the size of this block level element, and everything is right into their positions. So we have adjusted our images. We have implemented our own images into this carousel slider panel, and we have made them full width, full device width, and we have turned on some indicators right over here. But yet there's another problem. This thing is not auto changing. This image slider, it is not auto completing. So in order to make some auto movement into this slider, we need to implement some added code into it.